Hello, everyone. 1 year old and 5 months, Theodore D. Samuel. He brought immense happiness into his, for his parents, to his relatives, and the family. Every day, the parents enjoyed the moments with him. Until one day, Theo was diagnosed with a rare genetic disorder, Wiskott-Aldrich syndrome. The entire happiness in the family dozed away. Every day seemed to be a hell. They wanted to get rid of all these things, but they couldn't. The diagnosis boy was taken to an hospital where he was given several treatments. Eventually, they identified that this syndrome could be treated only with a stem cell transplantation. The process took over 6 months that the stem cell transplant donor has to be identified from international market. And the stem cell has to reach our India, and the process has to go further. It took almost 6 months. But what if this disease, this rare genetic disorder, was predicted very primarily? All the process could have been done initially, and it is ready for a stem cell transplantation. The family would have been prepared mentally to face the situation. This is where we want a science called predictive science. I am Lalin Laudis, who is working for the past few years in predictive science. The need for prediction in healthcare. It is estimated that around 2050, the number of people aged 50 and above with at least one chronic disorder is anticipated to double from what it was in 2020. And there comes the need for predictive science. Let us do a thought experiment. Assume that we know very well in advance about the illness that is brewing inside us. What if I say you are about to be diagnosed with diabetes in the next 5 years? Wouldn't you be conscious on your diet? Wouldn't you change the diet, the lifestyle? Definitely you would. Because everyone wants to live long, everyone wants to live happy, and everyone wants to live healthier. This is where we again need predictive science. The predictive science changes the reactive healthcare approach to one that is more proactive. I'll explain it. This is the limitation of traditional healthcare. The word traditional, what I mean is the healthcare system or the diagnostic system that we follow today. The major limitation of today's healthcare system is it is reactive. Assume that you have a fever. What we do? We just meet a medical practitioner, get some pills, and wait for a week, right? So once the fever subsides, it is okay. But if it is not, we'll again meet the same practitioner, take some medical blood test or something diagnosis, and then we'll find to figure out what the problem is. So this is what I call it is reactive. So traditional healthcare is primarily reactive. But shifting the healthcare from reactive treatments to proactive prevention is what we anticipate, and that is what predictive science is. So what is predictive science? We all might have learned machine learning. At least we would have known machine learning. We all would have learned statistics, correct? We all would have learned data analytics. So predictive science is nothing much bigger. It is the combination of data analytics, statistics, and machine learning. It is a disguised form. So what actually it does is, it uses the data, and with complex algorithms, makes some models, and forecasts the outcome. Let me explain. How does the predictive science work in healthcare? And I'm sure we would all have taken air transportation. Have you ever wondered how many wearable devices we carry with us during the security check. Probably 4 to 8 wearable devices we do carry with us. All these electronic gadgets do collect data from us, right? All these electronic gadgets analyzes our behavior, right? So we can use that in the most effective form. Predictive science take information and health records from wearable devices, from our lab test reports, and by using very powerful algorithms, make sense out of it. Dr. L was suffering from memory loss. Dr. L was suffering from memory loss. Who is Dr. L? He is nothing but the person who is speaking before you. So he has a forgetting disorder. He was trying to delve further into it. And he identified that it is a form of neurodegenerative disease. When going very further, he saw that Parkinson's disease was more likely in the form of neurodegenerative diseases. So we all might be aware of Parkinson's disease. So Dr. L and his team wanted to find some solution. Unfortunately, Parkinson's disease doesn't have a proper medication as of now. There is no solution. But if you diagnose it very priorly, you can defer the symptoms to an extent. So that was the challenging part. So Dr. L and his team were working on some predictive techniques. During discussions with several medical practitioners, doctors, they identified our speech signal is flooded with information. So our speech signal has 21 features, out of which there is a feature called MFCC. We call it as malfrequency septal coefficient. This feature is directly responsible for predicting Parkinson's disease. When there is a variation observed in this MFCC feature, it is directly associated with Parkinson's disease. Imagine a world. This product or this methodology is being incorporated in the smart watches which we use today. These watches takes your speech signal very commonly, analyzes your speech signal very rapidly, and informs you, hey there, you are going to be diagnosed with Parkinson's disease in next 5 years. Wouldn't you take immediate actions for this? Definitely we would. This is the power of predictive science. And this methodology has already produced 82% of success rate. Very similarly, the most common disease which we see across is diabetes. Yes? India is supposed to be the diabetic capital of India, allegedly informed by some media. If I take a sample size of 100 people, possibly half of you would be diagnosed with diabetes. But what is the solution? Trust me and believe me when I say just your urine sample, your age, and your family history would definitely predict diabetes before its occurrence. And trust me when I say you will definitely change your lifestyle. Who doesn't want to be healthier, correct? You will definitely change your lifestyle. You will definitely change your dietary pattern. And you will be free from diabetes. Challenges. Predictive science definitely comes with its own challenges. The major challenges that diagnostic people inform us, the medical practitioners inform us, is privacy in data. They don't want to disclose the data of their patients. But it is a trade-off. Unless you get this data, our algorithms cannot be trained. And unless you can't train an algorithm, you can't get the proper output. This is a major challenge in disease prediction. And also, have you seen in the previous slides, Dr. L worked on Parkinson's disease because he was affected with it. Not directly, but a small memory issue, neurodegenerative issue. And Dr. L was also delving into diabetes as his parents and few of his relatives were diagnosed with this problem. So let me invite you to start from the disease that affect your inner being the most. That is what we call it as empathy. Only you, when you feel the pain, you will act. So now, the future of predictive science is far widened, not limiting itself with Parkinson's disease or it is a diabetes. It has a wide scope in all the field of healthcare. So I wanted to introduce this science to you. I want you people to delve into this science and make wonders out of it and produce many algorithms that could predict the diseases very prior. This is the time to call for an action. Researchers are here, technologists are here, medical practitioners are here, diagnostic people are here. This is a time where each and every one should handshake to create a new system. We call it as interdisciplinary and transdisciplinary fields. Everyone should join hands, share the wit, share the knowledge among themselves so that the science evolves. Together, we have the chance to make this unimaginable into a reality, to predict the future, to make it as a healthier one. And let's change the dynamics, obviously, of healthcare for a happier planet. Thank you.